It's a marvelous night for a moon dance with the stars above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance neath the cover of October skies.
My story here, which, my friends, is a little creepy. It is a little weird. However, it's a love story. Keep that in mind. Throughout it all, love will prevail. Don't forget that. Everything else aside. Our story has to do with a gentleman by the name of Karl Tanzler. Karl Tanzler was German in origin. However, he moved down here for the sole purpose of finding love. You see, in his dreams back home, he would say that his grandmother, the Countess Anna, would come to him and tell him that he needed to seek out a dark-skinned beauty like no other, that she was going to be his wife, and that she was going to be the one whom he would spend eternity with. Why he chose Key West, we don't know, but he did. He moved down here under the name Count. Not Karl Tanzler, but Count Von Cosel. I don't know. Titles are better than names, I guess. Fair enough. Here's the thing. He moved down here. Worked as an X-ray technician at the Naval Hospital. It was here that one day, 1929, a woman came into his office whom he immediately recognized as, well, to him, his future wife. The love of his life, the woman who had been sent to him in a dream, the woman who he had seen. Now, unfortunately, there were a few things wrong. First and foremost, unfortunately, she was ill. She had tuberculosis. She did not have long to live. The Count showered her with gifts and love and appreciation beyond measure. But there was another small problem. She was still technically married. For you see, after she had unfortunately miscarried her and her husband's child and been diagnosed with tuberculosis, he abandoned her. He left her here, effectively to die alone. But then she met the Count. She was still terminally ill, however. But he provided the best medical care he could at no cost to her. And when she did finally pass away in 1931, the funeral was held right across the street over there, that light is. Now, there was a few hundred people at her funeral, but this would be her first funeral. There would be another, and I will get there. You see, the Count was so in love with this woman. She meant more to him than anything in the world. As I'm sure many of you are understand when you are in love, how that feels. He paid for the entire ceremony. He paid for her to have a beautiful mausoleum in our cemetery. And as the story goes, he paid for a phone to be installed in her mausoleum so he could call her and talk to her. When he couldn't call her, he went to visit her daily. He went to visit the love of his life. The term, till death do us part, seemed to play nothing in his mind. But visiting her was not enough, my friends. He wanted her with him. He wanted to see her daily. He didn't want to have to travel to the cemetery. He wanted to sleep with her, to hold her, to love her. So one night, shortly after she had been buried, he stole her body from the mausoleum, and he brought it back to his house. He wired her bones together. He kept her clothed. He made sure her face remained intact with modeling wax. He would stuff her body with clothing to keep it from degrading. He would buy her clothes and presents, perfume to keep the smell away. And did it die?
Not enough storage.
Oh. Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's a shame.
5 minutes into it.
You're filming, right?
Mm-hmm.
We could probably get your email
okay.
and send it.
Then he can do it. That was horrible timing. The Count and Elena Hoyos, it would seem, were inseparable. But he had a secret. Of course, the secret was her. With two incomes, one from his job at the naval yard, and one from some mysterious stipend from Germany, he was able to provide for his wife. Did I say wife?
Yeah.
I did. Because shortly after he took her body back to his house, they got married. A little private ceremony. One assumes just the two of them and the priest, of course. But the Count believed nothing. Not even death could keep them apart. Love knows no bounds, my friends.
Who stole the cookie from the cookie jar?
Babe!
Will you marry me?
Of course!
Get on your knee, put on your finger. Come on, dude. Don't be cheap.
Okay. I got it.
A lot of time with this.
I love you, baby.
Much kiss.
By the way, you're still being recorded.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah,
I had no idea that was coming. Congratulations. And now I shall finish my tale. The Count kept his new wife's body for 7 years in his home where they lived together. However, we don't know why, but it would seem at some point her sister found out what was going on. And as I'm sure, I hope, any of your immediate family would be, we're quite concerned. She reported the Count to the authorities. But as the story goes, there was about a 5-day gap between when she found out and when she reported it to the authorities. When she did, however, and those 5 days are important, and I will get back there, what happened was he was arrested. He was brought to the Monroe County Courthouse. However, his crime, it would seem, that of grave robbing, only had a statute of limitations of 5 years. And the case was dismissed, thrown out. He had to take a psych eval as well, but he was deemed mentally competent. And I know that may come as a surprise to some of you, but let's be honest. It's Key West, Florida. Most of us down here are mentally competent. He left the island shortly thereafter. Her body buried in a secret location. He went back to the mainland of Florida, where he lived out the rest of his life. But there's a theory. There is a theory. For you see, when he died, when his body was discovered, it would seem as though he was laying in the arms of a reconstructed effigy of his beloved wife. There are no reports. There is no factual evidence. As I said, there is a theory that within those 5 days, what the Count did was switch the bodies. Perhaps he went into the graveyard, dug up another, reconstructed it to look like his beloved wife, and hid her actual body away. Because he knew what was going to happen. As I said, no facts, but there is the theory that even when he died, he was laying in the wife, excuse me, in the arms of his loved one, whom he had done everything within his power to spend as much of his life as he could. As I said, a little weird, but a love story nonetheless. And with that,
inside a man.